again to what I consider something of a laboratory experiment in musicology. In the same state, sometimes on the same stage, Vietnamese musicians currently residing all over the world. As part of this festival, we have over 23 events featuring at least 11 groups and individuals, and they come from, and how its branches survive in different parts of the world today. So with that as a pretext, I invite you to come not to just one event, but to more than one event to get a different perspective on different ways of approaching Vietnamese traditional culture. As soon as you mention Vietnamese traditional music, what you must also do in the same breath is think of Tran Quang Hai and Bach Ian, our guest today. I won't recite the resume for you here today because it's long enough already, and in fact it's become just like...
Dòng mây trắng dập xuống nước trắng lại when he sings, we won't sing. But when we sing, he will sing anyway. So please try one more time and don't forget. Ho la quang.
Ho la quang.
Back in the choir, we have the general rehearsal. So whenever you see this sign, you sing "Ho La Ha Quang," and you look at me because by that time I will sing. And then every time the signal comes back, you sing "Ho La Quang."
Mời bạn Ho Quang,
Ho La Quang,
đi quang Ho Quang,
Ho La Quang.
Very good. Now we sing for real. Don't forget that we are all workers, and when we work, we have to sing loudly.
Ho vang,
ho la vang,
đi vang ho vang,
ho la vang,
chú đen đông càng,
ho la vang,
mà còn dưới đồng sâu,
ho la vang,
trong đi cày vợ đi cày nè,
ho la vang,
con trâu mà đi vừa,
ho la vang,
đi vang ho.
Hồ La Quang,
chứ tìm mà em.
Hồ La Quang,
như thế tìm chim.
Hồ La Quang,
chim bay về bắc.
Hồ La Quang,
anh tìm về đông.
Hồ La Quang,
đi quang hồ quang.
Hồ La Quang,
chứ tình mà em.
Hồ La Quang,
như thế dòng sông.
Hồ La Quang,
thương anh mà ảo đặt.
Hồ La Quang,
phòng không một mình.
Hồ La Quang,
đi quang hồ quang này.
Hồ La Quang,
đi quang hồ quang.
Hồ La Quang.
Thank you.
About the lovely weather, she would sing poetry and a beautiful poem, or she would give a new recipe to her child. And so if this is the case, here is a lullaby from South Vietnam. Maybe the South Vietnamese women are more open. So while she in his suit, you must add a little bit of chives, a little bit of pepper, etc. And suddenly she would add, oh my dear husband, you are leaving me and the children. The children, I am carrying them on my left arm and I am accompanying my mother-in-law with a big basket of flowers on my head. And as you know, in South Vietnam it's very warm. Sometimes it gets to 40 degrees in the shade. And they put the baby on the hump and do it like this. Oh, tay dắt mẹ chồng mà đầu đội thung bông.
Two string instrument, and in the south we're gonna we call it đàn cò, đàn instrument cò to bow. So this instrument existed in China, and in China they call it hǔqǐ. Hǔqǐ that means the barbarian instrument, because the Chinese thought that all the instruments coming fixed between the two strings. So you never lose your bow when you travel. And then when you bow, you never bow two strings at the same time. And you see that the violin, you have to put the instrument under the chin. But here you put the instrument between the two knees. So with this one, you can see that this string is used like the capodas string. You can move up and down, and then you can change the pitch without changing the position of the finger. For example, we don't have the absolute pitch as in Western music. So that's why we can tune the instrument according to the voice of the singer, etc. Except when we play in the ensemble, we have to tune the instrument according to the flute. This is the European scale with 7 tones. But in Vietnam we don't use this scale. We only have 5 tones. So that's why we suppress 2 degrees and we have the pentatonic scale. We sing Ho Su Sang Se Gong Liu Gong Se Sang Su Ho. And then you can see, for example, we have this bridge. You can use the knee to press against the bridge and you can play it very soft. Immediately that we can tune, because most of the violinists, they have to suit in. Sometimes they put here in this pocket and this pocket, and when they play, and now, oh, where is my shooting? Like, so they waste their time. For us, we just practice one, immediately we can play very soft. So, we are, you know, just the people who like to spend less effort and to get the maximum amount. For example, you are going to hear something like this. One folk song from North Vietnam, love song, and performed by Kien. And then we are going to sing, voila, the egret is over.
The egret is over on the top of the village, and here to the queen, oh my lord. haunted me.
You go your way, you're going
Just to introduce the audience into the boat. So in the South, we use the term rao. Rather, that means just to say something when you want to sell the products in the market. Rao, you have the free, you know, the I'd like to show you, this is the percussion created by the Vietnamese people. It is called shin diem, or the coin clappers. This instrument is composed of three separate wooden pieces, two fitted with coins. And we hold the two pieces with coins in one hand, like this. And you clap together. You can hear the sound of the clappers. If you shake the coins, you can hear the sound of the system. The third piece that you scrape underneath, you can hear the sound of the scrapers. And now, you are going to hear how we play this instrument. This instrument was used to perform in the court orchestra in the center.
Hãy subscribe cho kênh Ghiền Mì Gõ để không bỏ lỡ những video hấp dẫn.
because of the playing. Many years ago, when I was young, I learned this flute in Vietnam. And when I arrived in Paris, I thought that spoons was created by the Vietnamese. Even if we always eat rice with chopsticks. But when we play music, always with spoons. So you are going to see how we developed the art of playing with spoons. And so I met American players, Canadian players, Russian players, many people in the world, and Turkish people, people from Madagascar, and so on. And in Asia, in Vietnam, Philippines, Indonesia, we play with spoons, but not as well as the European people when you can hear in bluegrass and in Cajun music or in country music. But I would like to show you how we Vietnamese people play with spoons. We have two basic training techniques. First of all, you have to warm up the wrist. Like this, flexible grips. Very flexible. And then, flexible fingers. And finally, you have the very flexible fingers.
And you have the hands.
And thanks to that, you can play the spoons in the Vietnamese way. Now, I would like to show you. This is two oriental spoons. You can find in any restaurant. It's free. Then, you can play like this. This is the percussion. What is very important is the space between the two parts of the spoons. You hold it very firmly and you play like this. One, two. This is the 2-beat rhythm. You go fast and fast. Change the position of the spoon. And now, three. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. And look at my fingers. I have to bend the fingers. Now, three fingers. Four fingers. Display the five fingers. And then along the arm. For the getting reason, he's got the cows off. And now we hit against the mouth. But before that, you should take up the teeth first. Now I transform the spoons into synthesizer. You don't need to buy any Yamaha or Casio. And you can play the pop music. Very good.
of matter, any object which has the fixed frame, the flexible tongue, you put the instrument against the mouth as a resonator. It is called juicing. And it has three different sounds. First sound, you apply, you know, close the instrument against the teeth. You pluck the tongue, and you can hear the fundamental. Second sound, you blow through the instrument. By blowing, you create the rhythm. Third sound, you move the tongue inside of the mouth. You modify the mouth cavity and you change the pitches. So with these different sounds, we can make music.
Thank you.
tribal people in Vietnam. And in Vietnam, we have 50 different minorities. They have different languages. They have different musical instruments. And this comes from the Hmong people, the male. You see, this is the Jusa. Fixed frame, flexible tongue, and put the instrument against the mouth. You can hear the Jusa of the Hmong people. I know that there are a few hundred Hmongs living in Minneapolis, and there's just one priest, Hmong priest, that just now ordered here, I think that from the church in Minneapolis.
Number six.